What's up, my fam? I don't know about you, but I can't wait for that new Brawl Hopper game. Brawl Hopper!
Hey everyone, welcome back. If you haven't seen episode 1 of the devlog yet, you're definitely want to check that out first. In this video, the plan is to mostly work on various refinements and chores towards release. As you just heard, I've officially named the game Brawl Hopper, essentially combining Arena Brawler with Cloud Hopper, which you can now wishlist on Steam, iOS, and Google Play. Before we get into it, everyone wants to know how I managed to get verified on YouTube. But instead of answering that question, I'm going to flex that I also got verified on Spotify, and you can now listen to the Brawl Hopper soundtrack on any of your favorite music platforms. The track is even recognized by Instagram, Siri, and Shazam. Give it a try on this video while you're watching. If you're interested in remixing the music, hit up the link in the description and I may include it in the game. Anyways, I started off with adding some dedicated UI buttons to better handle jumping and shooting on mobile, though I made sure that you can still crouch via the joystick as well. Then I wanted to go ahead and add a few details to the player character, nothing permanent but just enough to make them look less like an ibuprofen commercial. Next, I wanted to add some weapons and power-ups to generate in between rounds, since currently not much happens. First, I started off with some health power-ups, currently borrowing a free asset for testing but will replace with something more modern a bit later. As you can see, works as expected, giving the player a 50 HP boost. More power-ups to come. After that was all working, I noticed that the platforms and character were a bit difficult to see whenever the time of day shifted to nighttime. So I started experimenting with how to add glow effects to my platforms. My first attempt at glowing was to implement various point lights within the platforms. Was kinda digging just yellow lights, but it also gave a bit of a guild member vibe. So I started experimenting with various colors and levels, but discovered it was hard to have the entire platform illuminated without overamping the intensity. I realized I may have to implement the glow effect via an entirely different technique. I decided to take a pause and shift back to power-ups, where I improved the health pack with a new green glow bubble effect, and added a weapon power-up that currently only refills to gun stamina, as there aren't any other weapons at the moment. Both power-ups self-destruct after 10 or so seconds. As I was in an experimental mood, I became curious what the game was looking like from the character's perspective, so I threw on a first-person camera and gave it a whirl. Playing around with the first person and depth of field definitely makes me want to dabble with some VR in the future. After making that new camera, I went ahead and also made a revolving camera that I may end up using for the game's trailer and perhaps this devlog series. Next, it was time to go ahead and add a volume slider to the pause menu. Gotta be considerate of the user's eardrums. It was simple enough to add a global volume slider, but in the future I might break it up into two sliders, one for music and the other for sound effects. Then I moved on to post-processing. Always appreciate a nice vignette. I played around with the various effects, but didn't end up using most of them, since things like depth of field aren't very handy with the current in-game multi-target camera setup. After those additions, it was time to knock out a few chores. Went ahead and implemented a small banner ad below the health bars, as well as a remove ads button on the pause menu. These, of course, will only show up on the iOS and Android releases. The next chore was implementing a nag screen to get reviews. Happy enough with how it looks, and it will only pop up after you've played a couple games, so hopefully it won't be too intrusive. The last chore was hooking up the various in-game achievements and leaderboards within Google and Apple's developer portals. Starting off with a basic most kills leaderboard, but may add more in the future. While testing on mobile, I decided to go ahead and add some haptic vibrations to the touch controls to give players that extra bit of feedback. Lastly, I wanted to add some transitional text to top off the UI, one for when the match begins and the other to announce the winner. Also threw on a confetti particle effect to the in-game camera for whenever you win. It turned out pretty solid. Now that the chores were done, I could finally turn back to focusing on my platforms. No more point lights anymore. I started playing with some textures to emit light through. I grabbed one off Google and made it my own. but the results reminded me of the PlayStation 2 days. Then I had an idea for a more refined look, and came up with a quick border texture. Ended up being exactly what I was going for. As a last bonus, I wanted to add a lighting effect to the bullet and also the player. As you can see, the eyes and hair now emit. Anyways, I appreciate you watching to the end of the video. Definitely hit the subscribe button if you haven't, and let me know your thoughts below.